What's up, everybody? So I just received a big box in the mail, and I thought I would share it with everybody. This is going to be probably one of my big projects for next year, 2023. And this was really wasn't a jet that I was expecting to get, but let me go ahead and just show you what I've got. And let me say, the guy really packed this thing incredible. So, if any of you have ever built one of these, you probably know what it is by now. This is a Byron F-15. Guy Dave, he goes by Pro Builder. I guess he made molds off of a Byron and then laid it up in epoxy. And holy cow, this thing. It's like double the stiffness of original Byron, at least. And man, no pinholes, because I bet I spent an extra year on redoing my Byron F-15, just primer and sand. I mean, I probably spent a year getting that thing ready for paint. And this thing looks like it just needs, you know, scuffed up a little bit, and then one short shot of primer, and it's probably ready for paint. Man, it's just absolutely beautiful. And wow. Yeah, it's so much more rigid. And well, the original Byron, it was designed to fly on two 91, or probably at the time 77, ducted fans. So they had to make it as light, because I think the completed plane flew at 23 pounds. But I think Dave beefed this up a bit for people that, you know, want to put a make it electric ducted fan or even turbine. And because what is, anybody that follows my channel know, I just completed a Byron F-15. I put two King Tech 85s in it. And the thing flew so amazing that I was like, man, I really wish I could have another one, but I didn't want to go through the ordeal of, getting another Byron and having to go through the whole, reglassing it and to strengthen it. And like I said, all the pinholes that you had to deal with. But I remember there was a guy in California that used to advertise these, that he had, redone the Byron F-15. And I mean, I remember looking at the pictures and just thinking, man, they're amazing. But at the time I didn't have, like wing cores and stuff like that. But now that I actually have when I bought the one that I redid, it came with an extra set of wing cores. And I think I can get a hold of Fabow and get their horizontal and vertical stabs from them. And so, and the guy Pro Builder, he actually makes the canopies for it still. So now I've got, with his fuse, I've got pretty much all the parts that I would need to build one. And man, this is just, wow. Really amazing. So yeah, it's got all the panel lines on it, which the Byron, by the time you filled it in to get all the pinholes out, all the panel lines are pretty well gone. But this one, wow, really amazing. And anyways, Dave, he was going to set his up for twin turbines too, so he made me a real good deal on the two pipes that he was going to use. So now I've got the pipes, and so this should be a really, since I've already done one, I pretty much, know all the engineering challenges that I'll be facing, and, I've already figured them out, so, I know where to put my bulkheads. I think this time, though, the difference I'm going to do, I'm going to put a set of electric gear in it, and put normal rails, where my other ones, I kind of did a custom deal where the retract mounts are mounted on the side of the fuse. But this one, I think I'm going to go with a little bit more traditional, but with electron retract, so all the gear will be electric. This is just absolutely amazing. It really is. If you've ever built the original Byron and know how flimsy it is, and this one, see all the doors are still there. Where the Byron, you've got to fill in the cheater hole, and it's just a whole nother bunch of work for you to do. And look, this is just unbelievable. How much work it's gonna save. That fits just amazing. Wow. So anyways, this will be one of my, if you've seen my previous video, I'm working on a Zirelli Hellcat. So I'm hoping to have that wrapped up in another month or two. And then I'll probably be getting this one ready to go. I'll probably be starting to make some formers for it in the meantime when I got a little spare time when I'm not working on the Hellcat. So this look for this to be flying in 2023. And catch everybody later. Bye.